to myself, this is great. I can do this. I thought that was how it was like for everybody in LA. Everybody makes money immediately. That's not how it works out. So that lasted about 6 months. The well ran dry. The songs weren't that good. And so I was facing the decision of either moving back to Orlando, which one of my producers decided to do, or stay and fend for myself and figure some things out. So I decided to stay. Thank goodness. And then one of the other producers decided to stay as well. So we went from a three-bedroom, three-story penthouse off the beach situation to living in the valley in a one-bedroom. Bunch of big buff dudes. And then where you stay. So the next couple years were a bit of a roller coaster of ups and downs. One of the ups was I got to tour with Anthony Hamilton for a few years. Did that, and one of the downs was I had a telemarketing job for a long time. People who wanted to cheat me. But actually, at that telemarketing job, I met one of my dear friends who helped co-write all the songs on this album, Mr. Michael Diskin. That's where I met him. I said, yeah, well. So I was broke, and you know, broke, busted, disgusted, couldn't be trusted, because my dad's in it. And eventually, you know, a couple years had passed, and I get a phone call one day. And back then, I didn't have a nice cell phone. I couldn't, no caller ID or anything, just numbers. Which I usually don't answer, you know. I usually owe somebody money at that point. So I was leery of answering the phone, but I was like, you know what? What can it hurt? Hello? Hey, what's up, Phil? It's Key. Oh, okay, cool. Hey, what's up, Key? What's going on, man? Like, yo, man, I got this kid. Working with him for a while. He's from Hawaii. I don't know, man. He's, you know, he's signed to a label, but I think they want to drop him because they don't really know what to do with him. But I think he can be big, man. I think he's super talented. So, but I think he needs a writer to help him get his ideas out. So I thought of you. So at that moment, I was in LA, and everybody says that. Everybody says they have that next big thing. So I was just like, because I was, you know, the West Side, he was over in the Valley, which is about, because I was on public transportation, I was taking the bus. So it's going to take me about 2.5 hours. Yeah, thank you. So, alright, man, dog, I got $5 to my name. He said, well, man, whatever it costs you to get here, I'll reimburse you. Thanks, man. If you throw something on top, that'd be cool too. No pressure. So I buy my bus ticket, and I can remember being on the bus, right? Thinking to myself, yeah. experience and affects every decision that you make. It can lead you this way, or it can lead you that way. Sometimes it can be a little stressful, but I think it's safe to say that sometimes, if we just breathe, it's gonna be hard.
Get it.